Roger Simons for Antigone 34. Unfortunately, Roger's not able to be here tonight, but we have Johan Town to come and to receive the reward.
Hello, I'm here representing my very old friend Roger, he'd like to say it's a massive honour to be awarded this famous sword, and he'd like to thank everybody involved in making it happen. He'd also like to mention his friend, dear friend Enrico, and to bring this sword home to his home will give Enrico a permanent place in his house, as it already is in his heart. That's what he'd like to say. He's sorry he couldn't be with you. He's enjoying himself in San Francisco. Thank you. Good night.
And the winner is Mark Kenyon for Strictly Come Dancing.
It's been a long journey. It's been 9 years, I think. I've had amazing teams, a team effort. Roger Williams, Darren Lovell, Gemma, Rachel, 9 amazing spot operators, an amazing set design, and, you know, it's just a team effort. Costume design, just fantastic. And we have a great ball, and we're looking forward to this year. We're back to Wembley this year, and it's, you know, we start tomorrow, in fact, so it's in the studio now, and we're looking forward to it.
The winner is Rob Mansfield for MasterChef.
I'm not sure who's more shocked, me or Andy Collins. Look, just a couple of thank yous, because I don't do speeches and I'm certainly not going to start tonight. A couple of thank yous to Shine TV, Karen Ross, Dave Ambler. Trusted me with this one when he went to the big studio, and Robin Johnson, my gaffer, been there for 8 years, camera crews, and to my wife Nat, who's sat over there. Thank you very much. Have a good night.
Nigel Catmull for the Royal Variety Performance.
Well, thank you very much. Very unexpected. And I must thank Lee Connolly and Fiona Clark for booking me in the first place. And all voices going, getting very nervous now. My operators, Dave Bishop and Oliver Lifley and Ross Williams, and my gaffer and his amazing crew who put it all in and made it happen. Thank you very much. Cheers.
And the award goes to Neil Carson for Chasing Status.
Thank you very much. Thank you to Tom Lesh and Andy Hurst, who helped start my career, and of course Nick Moran and Mike Oates as well. So thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of our stage award, Neil, everybody.
And the award goes to Davey Sherwin for Snow Patrol.
Hey, I'd like to thank Mike Oates from HSL mainly and XL Video. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for our winner there, Davey. Thank you very much.
I've always wanted to say this, and the winner is David Finn for Sweet Violets. Unfortunately, David Finn cannot be here, but I believe Simon Bennison is here, who will pick up the award on his behalf.
Hi there. Well, David was meant to send me some words to read out, but he didn't. So all I'll say is that it's quite incredible for all three pieces nominated to have come from the Royal Opera House. And so I should thank all of the crew, all of the staff, and all the people that made the shows happen. And also to thank David for coming over and making such a great show. He's a really super designer and a very worthy winner of the award. Thanks.
Ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause, please, for David, the winner of the Dance Lighting Award. Marvellous. Thank you, sir.
And the winner is DM Wood, who sadly, you may have heard this line before, cannot be with us, so John Paul Percox is accepting on her behalf.
Yes. Thank you, everyone. DM particularly asked me to thank the Royal Upright Lighting Department for all their hard work, and it couldn't have made it happen without them. She also wanted to thank Miriam Buerta for a wonderful set design, and Sue Usher and Susie Hickenbottom for bringing that design to realisation. And she also wanted to thank Richard Jones and the entire production department for all their hard work on the production. Great. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
And the award goes to Howard Harrison.
Thank you very much. I'm very surprised. Thank you. I'd just like to say the biggest thank you to my fellow nominee, David Plater, who was until very recently the chief electrician at the Donmar Warehouse, who David's enthusiasm, skill, and hard work made it quite simply one of the best places to work in London, and I feel very lucky I got to work there under him. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of our Drama Award, Howard. Don't think, sir. Thank you.
And the winner is Neil Austin, who sadly cannot be here, but Gary Longfield of Sheffield Theatres is here to accept on his behalf.
Thank you very much. I spoke to Neil early in the week to ask him if there was anything he'd like me to say should he win the award. He said, don't worry, you won't need to make a speech. He was wrong, but he did say thank you to myself and all the rest of my team at Sheffield and how much he really appreciated working on such a phenomenal show in the regions. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 2012 Enrico Caironi Award for Lifetime Achievement goes to Brian Leach.
Instructions of my wife, deep breath. So first of all, Commendatore Pasquale Quadri, multi grazie. And I make no apologies for being the umpteenth person tonight to mention Enrico Caironi. I would like to direct you to the Clay Paky website, and there's a memorial page for Enrico there. If you look on that, the first photo that comes off, a black and white photo of him in profile, absolutely. If ever one photo encapsulated one person, it's that one. Basically, he's the kind of guy, a bit like me, he didn't understand the meaning of the word no. If you hit him over the head with a baseball bat and got security to throw him out, he'd stick his head through the letterbox and say, I think that means yes, then yes. And it worked with Mr. Valdez and myself, because he got us to buy loads and loads of clay packy lights, and we've never regretted it. But anyway, so... I'm a lucky chap still to be here at all, and especially lucky to be here tonight. And a bit of a shock seeing Jamie there. So trust him to put a spike in for me. I was all okay until I saw that for some reason. But anyway, there's just so many people to thank. But you know, been here a long time, and I got helped up the ladder by a lot of people, and always believed in never pulling the ladder up behind you. You know, just make things happen. And the tools we had to work with when Valdez and I first started were quite a lot more primitive than what's here today. And that's what's going to be great for the future, because new designers that are coming up are there. Whereas Nick and I were more of analog people, they're definitely digital, and it's just going to get better and better. So that's what I look forward to, seeing things in the future. Even though I'm not involved anymore, I still keep an eye on things, can't help myself. And I just want to thank everybody for being so kind to me over the years. There was a laundry list of thanks, but I just feel it's probably the best way to not offend anyone is to just make it a general thing. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause, please, for our Lifetime Achievement Award winner, sir. Fantastic. The toast is to the light. To the light. Good luck, everyone. Oh, I got that there. But it is time now for a donation to Light Relief, and I would like to call on stage the trustee of Light Relief. Big round of applause, please. Welcome on the stage, Mr. Rick Fisher.
Thank you very much. It's a great pleasure to be here at this fifth award celebration. And I think, as we all feel, the spirit of Enrico Caironi is around us all. The generosity, the complete dedication to furthering the cause of what lighting can do and the pleasure that lighting gives in all of our areas of performance is what these awards are about. The charity that is here to help people in the lighting industry who've fallen on hard times. We are now celebrating what I believe is our 10th year. We've been constantly helping quietly and sometimes with a little bit more publicity people in the lighting industry who have suffered illness, suffered loss of mobility, whose partners have suffered illness and mobility which have stopped them working and helped them get back on their feet. And it's really wonderful that Clay Paky have included in their generous celebration of the talent of the lighting industry, but have also recognized the need to support people who need help at this time. So I think I'd like to call on Pasquale Quadri, the president of Clay Paky, to come on up. And it's a great pleasure. It's a very generous donation. Do you want me to say how much it is? Can I say?
Don't speak English.
I know. Well, all I can say that it's substantially more than a couple of fees of the shows that I'm doing at the moment, which I wish wasn't true, but alas it is. But it's a very generous donation on behalf of Clay Paky, and thank you. This will go to good use to support the lighting community in the UK. Thank you once again.
Thank you.